Welcome friends. Today, let us discuss about the skill how to manage change, that is change management. Managing change in life is one order, and managing change at the corporate level in the workplace is another order. Change is inevitable in all spheres of life. Recessions, promotions, physical transfers are some of the triggers that bring in change. Even technological changes, finances, company mergers, and business revamp will bring in change in more than one way. Dear friends, changes are synonymous with growth as well as setbacks. Hence, it is prudent to keep informed on various scenarios that involve changes which can particularly have a direct consequence on career growth as well as personal well-being. Yes, friends, there are different aspects that we have to look into. Stepping in as a new leader, leadership priorities, leadership during recession, globalization challenges, controlling the outsourcing effects, leading the company during change, handling disappointing company changes, reinforcing focus after change. Yes, we have to look into even introducing technological change, dealing with finances after business change, physical move after business change, rallying through business expansion, leading revamped small business, managing company during merger, refocusing the team after job loss, or managing change during merger and acquisition. It's a life. Life is so dynamic that we have to get ready to face any change. It is a process, because in change management, again we look into people, process and culture. Same thing, managing change in the organization has even a technology. So stepping in as a new leader, handling employees and the upper management is often a big task for the new leader. Being a leader, upper management in your organization will take a closer look on how you handle pressure, provide leadership, and ensuring productivity at the same time. Ensuring team reception. Being a new leader is not only a significant change on you, but on your team as well. Get out of your dust. Solicit. A leader is a leader. Always work with your employees individually and as a group so that mutual progress could be achieved. Dear friends, there are 7 steps for changing, which leads to change. Where are we now? Where are we now? The first step. Second is the team talk. Then you have a walk the talk. Then break the mold. You have to implement and consolidate, reinvigorate, and a new status due. Because you have to make a change, you have to go through all this process. What is the priorities of the leadership? Changes experienced in business setting is considered as a good sign in terms of business survival. Learning from the past, write down the events that led to the downfall or to the improvement of the company you are working with. If the company's movement led to its success, then it should be emulated. Yes, we should have setting goals. A leader should always be about goals and targets. A goal would mean that their actions actually have some effect on the business, and their continuing dedication will lead the company to new heights. Goals or targets should come into 2 formats: small goals and bigger goals. Company new needs to skills. company, change could also mean the change of needs of the customer or clients. At this point, you should be aware of your employees' individual skills. Although they all have impressive skills related to the industry, their additional skills should be considered as well. That's where we are giving this training. All of you are excellent, you know, but there's a lot of change too. So those who know, we are asking you to reinvent yourself or recharge yourself. And those who are learning, learn the new things. From customer to sales skills, each employee has a talent that might let him or her stand out in the group. These skills could be matched according to the new needs of the company. Though these skills, the team would slowly evolve, not just as simple employees, but as exemplary individuals that might be promoted. Dear friends, you should update your needs. Important to determine your needs to perform well. The company will never hesitate to offer support to their employees as long as they reach the expected output. Yes, the whole change management needs to be taken into consideration. Leadership during the recession. This is the worst part of a life, both for individuals, company, and the country. There will always be a leader in business, politics, community, or any other organization. Without a leader, the whole organization will crumble as no one will lead the group into doing something they have collectively decided. Yes, so what should we do? During recession, being a leader is anything but lucrative. A leader is pressurized to perform so that the company would eventually survive. This is a lot easier said than done, as the leader will have to deal with the challenging external factors. At the same time, the leader will have to deal with its followers who are emotionally and financially affected by recession. Dear friends, standing tall for the company is the need of the hour here. This is a good and bad thing. You inspire, encourage, and help them focus on the job. Your daily interactions with employees could easily help everyone do their tasks and possibly more efficiently. So, two heads are better than one during this time. Being a leader does not always mean that you are burdened with decisions alone. A leader is basically someone who can choose a decision presented by its employees, or would be someone who can seek the right decision through different actions. Yes, valuing individual perspective does not only have a positive impact for the business, but could also provide a positive psychological impact to your employees. Leadership during recession is not just about handling the entire burden of the organization. Always include your employees in the decision-making process during these times so that a better decision could be easily achieved. Dear friends, managing all types of people, all types of situations, all types of materials, and the whole time, everything has to be managed here. Globalization challenges. Globalization can be considered as a business move for a corporation if they want to significantly expand their business. For its employees, globalization means more opportunities. Globalization offers big changes for the company. What are the challenges of globalization? One aspect you will realize is that globalization actually slows down company process. Competition not only for business but also for a certain position should also be expected. Become an efficient leader. individual leadership. Adjusting culture with core values. Globalization has its pros and cons, but it does not have to be bad news the entire time. As a leader, believing in individual productivity, you should be able to harness their strengths for a better organization. So there are 8 stages of a change management. Go through each of the stages and work it out on those stages. Controlling the outsourcing effect. Instead of hiring someone locally, wherein they could have to pay more, a company could hire someone from a developing country and pay the employee less. Realizing local problems. Unfortunately, outsourcing could have adverse effects locally. Since jobs are being outsourced, local employment can significantly go down. Of course, in our country, we also live on outsourcing of more to our country. It comes from other countries to our country. So there has been a rise in the employment. Managing while outsourcing. There are 2 challenges that you have to face when your company opts to outsource. Dealing with new employees and using the latest technological advantage for managing. Local travel required. One of the well-known perks when the company undergoes changes for outsourcing is traveling to other countries. Outsourcing, one of the few business practices a company could consider to ensure profits without spending. Here I would like to tell you a small example which has taken place. 10 years back when I was in US, there I read that a company was outsourcing their work to India, but getting so much of work done, and there was no place for them to get a place here to outsource. So what they did, they have hired 800 people across the world, mostly Indians and Chinese. They rented out a big ship because H1 was a problem that time. So they have put all of them in the ship. Few furlongs, few miles from US, they have halted the ship. They anchored the ship there for 10 months, got their work done. They provided everything to them. They got their work done and sent all of them home. The employee is happy, the employer is happy. Yes, small projects are time-bound projects. Are taken up nowadays in this way because they want people to work 24/7. Now, what a novel idea it is. Sometimes the novel idea might misfire too, but we have to consider many of the things. Managers have to research a lot before they could become successful managers during outsourcing. You should be able to get in touch with your employees fast with the help of technology. The change management process is the most important. First, you should be readiness is the important thing. Then re-engineering and resilience. All these processes will help you. Leading the company during change. Change in business is a double-edged sword. It could become the turning point towards the company's success or failure. On the other hand, change can also become the reason for a company's downfall. The downfall and improvement of a company because of change does not happen without any factors. Dear friends, although the employees have a significant role in improving the company, the leaders are the determining factors towards the company's success or failure because of change. employees are only considered as followers. So we have to look into creating a plan and implementing these changes. Leaders during changes capture the spotlight not only because they become the forerunners specific changes for the company, they are also independent-minded individuals who have the ability to take risks on behalf of the company. Yes, the top management needs to understand and give the responsibilities to the middle management also to work on the changes. Leaders in the large corporations often have to work directly with employees, and certain decisions have to be done every day. Sometimes difficult situations require creative answers. There are employees who point to change as a reason for being unproductive. Dear friends, go through the process. There are five phases and in the change management. Assess for a change, prepare for a change, plan for a change, implement the change, and then sustaining the change. All these steps will help you to work for a change management, and you can manage the change in a much better way. Handling resistance and problems. Yes, during change there will be lot of resistance and there will be lot of problems. I always tell the employees, we should not resist the change. We should welcome, because it is for the betterment of individual and company, and in particular and in general for the country. One of the leader's basic responsibilities unique to change is to address resistance to the proposed changes. The managers have to explain changes carefully to their employees. A good leader should understand the concern of their employees as well. During change, problems could easily arise because of the unfamiliarity of the employees to new practices and even environment. Leaders have to provide not only solutions to some of the concerns, but also monitoring on the effects of the changes to the employees. Upper management support. In a business situation, leaders are the managers and supervisors who work directly with employees. The upper management should provide support as much as they can for their leaders, as these leaders only dream about the company improvement through business changes. So, what should we do? Handling disappointing company changes. The disappointing is the most important thing. There are times wherein the company change is bad news to its employees. Yes, I have gone through many times in my life, wherever I have stepped in, there used to be a lot of resistance. Because they know there will be a lot of change. But they did not know that opportunities and their welfare also needs a change. But as they work, they understand, and they understand what it is. In most of the cases, the employees are sometimes sidelined, or sometimes are not motivated properly, or sometimes are given wrong information. Employees should not go with the gossips. Should wait for the top management to tell what they want. But there are some people, mischievous, who will create commotion, and the employees don't know what to do and they resist and they feel disappointed, depressed. Employees will be easily disheartened by the news that even though the changes are not implemented yet, productivity will be greatly affected. So unnecessary things should not be said. Earlier the better. A leader is not only someone who bears the great news to its members. A leader should also be the bearer of the bad news. Seeking reasons and not individuals. Going after the person will yield nothing except more confrontation. But when the reason is examined, the solution or alternative could be sought out. Institution is above individual. If you think that you might be a good leader, you might implement everything, you are confident you can do it, but the employees are against it, and you think that the institution will get affected, step back. That is what I always feel. But if you know that the employees are being benefited, and you have time to make them understand, motivate them, then you can go forward and do many things. Leaders and possibly employees could converge, wherein each of them present a viable solution to the problem. Dear friends, mediate. How many of us can do that? As a counselor, I know. But where I want, I will mediate the best. But if I feel no need to mediate, just leave them, you should leave them. Leaders should be the voice of the employees as well as the voice of the upper management. Encourage the employees to voice out their frustration about the upper management in case something wrong happens. You should take care of the upper management, the institution, and also the welfare of the employees. Effective manage change. You have to. You are enablers. So the lesser the evil. When something bad happens to the company due to recent changes, a leader has to face the fact that there are situations that the only available options are the lesser evil. Do not be afraid and stand firm on your decisions. Yes. Yes means yes. No means no. Leadership, sponsorship, and project management go along with change management. Reinforcing the focus after the change. When a company experiences in a change management, you should have a proper planning. Experience changes in its business setting, one of the first things that they have to address is to get back on track and continue the business as soon as possible. Enforcing focus to establish company productivity once more is the hands of the company leader. I always motivate and advise employees should accept the upper management change management which they bring. The upper management wants a change. You should accept it. It is the good for the employees, because in most of the corporates, upper management is very dynamic and they are very good and they want to give everything to their employees, including training, not just the perks alone, because they want to make you all the best. Take it. Sometimes you may know it. If you know it, take an opportunity to imbibe it and implement it. The supervisors, managers, and anyone who has entry level, employees under them, has the responsibility of ensuring the company to go back on track after changes has been experienced in the company. Focus, a group effect. A single person focusing on its job will never matter, since everyone else will be dragging down the productivity of that single person. As a leader, you have to monitor your group consistently. Yes, dear friends, leaders have to go through a lot. When one person is doing some work, there will be 99 persons telling them that he is wrong. Even 10% joins their hands with him, lot more will be there. Of course, we also find 10% are involved in that change management. 80% do it because they are asked to do it. But then there are 10% who don't want to do anything. They don't want to support any change. And they will brainwash the other 80%. So this 80% have to be very careful not to join the hands with this 10% who are dragging you behind, but join with the 10% who want to take you up. We should see that you should give a hand to a person to help bring him up, not to a person where you feel that you will be also be drawn down. You will also be pulled down. So you have to be very careful. Define goals. Goals should be as concrete as possible so that the entire team will know their performance in relation to their preferred goals. The goals could be qualitative or quantitative, but it should be something that could be achieved by your employees. Dear friends, acknowledging individual strengths. Yes, we have to take advantage of the individual strengths and leave the weaknesses outside. Change is the perfect time to help employees determine what they can really do. Refocusing your team is more than just telling them to go back to work. Set achievable goals and value their inputs as well as additional value their inputs as well as additional skills to considerably improve your team in terms of additional services and continuing efficiency. Being a leader, always speak good of your work and never speak anything against the person who has already left. Who has left? Most of us give time and waste time in talking ill of others. Instead, we might waste time in speaking about a non-productive way. It is better we all join together and give our mind, our thought, our time for a productive activity. Introducing technological change. A business world is always a technological world today. Communication is also a lot easier and more affordable because of online connectivity. Technology is always evolving, that something new around the block will always come out and defeat a device or application introduced a year ago. Dear friends, introducing gadgets and software into the company also brings change. It is essential for managers to provide the right training to employees on how to handle the latest technology. Yes, please spend some time with your computer geeks, with your computer technologists to learn new things. Training the trainer. That's what we are doing now. We are training you because you all are the trainers. Managers should identify individuals who are fit in this position. A small company does not necessarily need to have a trainer, but the presence of one will help the business leader tackle simple problems related to the introduced technology. So work plus place is the potential. So we have to manage the change at workplace. Establishing protocols. Employees need to be reminded that the advancement of technology is for the advancement of business only and not for personal purpose or any another purpose the company prohibits. Monitoring and evaluation. Monitoring and evaluation should be part of the introduction process of new technology. The leaders in the business should always seek feedback from its employees regarding the technology. Dear friends, the change management is resistance. You have to understand dealing with finances after the business change. Yes, a main very core aspect of the business. Any business movement will require certain resources to be spent. Every stage of the change process has to be carefully done to avoid unnecessary spending. Let us understand the cost and return of investment. The increase in profits could actually be measurable, especially when there is an expected increase in financial earnings. Leaders and managers should also consider ease of operations as a reason why the cost for change is worth it. This change will not earn the company anything, but it will boost the morale, the employees, and will save them on transportation costs. Good friends, employee consideration is the most important. All of us are employees in one way or other. As a leader, it would be for the best of the company to hear their side first before making any decision. Although everyone is down because of the financial struggle, your employees could take comfort from the fact that the managers were able to hear out their employees. Yes, friends, money and performance is the most important aspect. During change, financial considerations always come into play. Business leaders should be able to harness their financial capability not only to improve the company but also to improve the employees' performance through additional compensation. Good friends, change management model is the continuous improvement. Yes, physical move after business change. There might be a change in the physical move. Businesses are always looking out for improvement all the time. Physical change can also be considered by a business if they wanted to ensure security of their operation. Transferring to another location could take time as important resources will be transferred. During the transfer, different problems could come up. How to secure the area? Inspection of the new property should also entail recognition consideration. A building is not just a building wherein employees could come in and work. It can also be used as a tool to attract more clients. Yes, friends, managerial considerations for employees. The scenario of spending more on fuel and traveling for additional hours could easily affect the productivity. The company needs to remember these factors before they actually decide to move out. Transferring to another city is a bad business decision when all your employees are located in another city. You might start a new one. The new one is not a change management. This will eventually force the business to spend more on transportation costs for their employees. This will actually be worth if the profits will improve. In a change management, options for managers to aid workers is the most important aspect. Consider telecommunicating. Telecommuting is a focus on work. Business movement is essential for a business to further improve its costs. But it should carefully consider the new location as well as its employees. Compromise should be achieved if a business wants to ensure the same productivity from its employees. Can we have a high-level endorsement? Can we have the gross revenue involvement, success stories, metrics? All these are change management. Relaying through business expansion. Business expansion is always a company prerogative. Expansion could even be product or service based, wherein they aggressively expand, not exactly through a new branch, but to a new product or service. Expansion is also good for the employees. Companies should ensure that their leaders, such as managers and supervisors, know how to handle this type of changes. Dear friends, aggressive expansion of a company could only become successful if the employees ensure that the expansion will work well. Without proper leadership and guidance, it would be very easy for the employees to get confused in their new task or in a new location. Action before expansion. The action plan does not have to be a 5-year forecast. Monitoring will eventually help the business leaders provide additional and this time longer action plans for the company to significantly improve. Dealing with service expansion. During service-based expansion, managers should also ensure that certain changes in the workforce will be as smooth as possible. Dear friends, the physical expansion is also considered as a change management. Expansion is a sign that a company improves, but expansion has to be carefully guided by its leaders and employees so that this specific type of change will only for the improvement of the company. How does this process take place? Leading revamped small businesses. Yeah. A big business also depends on the small businesses. I have seen a big company in Vizag, because I was working in that big company. Around our company, there used to be small businesses. In reality, most of our products were the products from the small company, and the big company used to depend on this small company. So we have to understand that the small companies around the big company needs to be taken care. A small business could easily become a highly profitable source of income. Revamping your small business is also not a walk in the park. You have to understand that. Your employees, no matter how small they are in a number, could be easily affected if you do not conduct this change properly. The good thing about revamping a business is that compared to starting, you don't have to deal with too many paper pushing and business planning alone. How do we have to deal with leadership by delegation? Establishing change in your small business requires the assistance of everyone. Delegating tasks don't even have to be based on certain aspects of business changes. Micromanagement needs to be looked into. An important trait a leader should have in dealing with change on a small business is the ability to micromanage. This is actually a personal practical move, since your employees are there to ensure continuous operation, but they are essentially your ticket to success. Worst case scenario. What can be a worst case scenario? To prevent the worst from coming to reality, formulate a worst case scenario plan. I was shocked when 8-9 years back, I had gone visited a mining township for a survey work. To see the scenario, the mining was not working, the company was not working, but the township flourished. How? After the company became sick, the township which was there, the company gave away all the quarters and everything to their employees. And they asked them, you stay, own it, but you can go and find a job somewhere else. And the township is still there, people are there, but none of them are working in that mining. So when I was surveying this, it was shocking that can a sick company do such things, and they have done it. So we have to be very careful with the corporate when we work on it. A small business is very fragile, so every precaution has to be taken to achieve success in the chosen industry. Whether it is a small business or a big business, our business is to work honestly. Managing company during merger. Yes, many companies do get mergers. Merger means two companies becoming a single entity, and this will entail merging some of their functions. Instead of spending money on two departments with the same function, a department could also be merged to reduce the cost. Merger and acquisition is easy when you are dealing with upper management. The lower management, such as supervisors and managers, could find themselves in a lot of pressure since they will face significant changes. This type of leadership is even more crucial since this will ensure that the company survives through their employees. Dear friends, there are types of takeovers. General guidelines: a takeover, an acquisition, and a merger, an amalgamation, all these needs to be looked into it. Cash transaction or share transaction or going private transaction need to be looked into. So classification of mergers and acquisitions also should be looked into. Horizontal, vertical, or cross-border. Now all these are academic subjects, but most practical ways to do it. Now documentation might be there, but we should know how to work with it. Mergers and acquisition activity is more important. It seems to come in the waves through the economic cycle, domestically or in response of globalization issues. Managing before the merger, there are two things that you should take care of before the merger as a leader: psychological fear and continuing business activity. The former is a lot more difficult to control for the leaders, since no matter what happens, there is always that fear of merger and acquisition becomes job losses could be expected. During and after the merger also, we have to be very careful, because it's a change management. Managing a change, handling the department during merger and acquisition is very challenging. In the same way, refocusing the team after the job loss. If anybody is losing the job, you have to refocus them. Job loss is a very devastating for the terminated employee. But job loss is equally devastating for the company as well as its retained employees. Because a very good employee might suddenly lose a job for whatever is the reasons. Leadership required in handling job loss. The following some essential tasks the leader should implement as soon as job losses in the company have been experienced. First is easing fear and refocusing goals. It is never the same situation. Saying business as usual after a significant job loss is never good. With the number of employees reduced to bare essentials, it is never a regular business scenario. So dear friends, as a leader, you should find solutions to your weaknesses by harnessing what you can do as a group today. It's a difficult task because of the job loss, but if everyone just does their assigned task, further job losses could be averted. There are no job losses for the people who really do their good work. Dear friends, let us do a small exercise. Using sequence chart, please write about how you manage change in your company. It can be a recent change, or in this particular company, or in any other company. How did you do it? Use the sequence chart you are given here. Thank you. Welcome friends. Today we'll be discussing about your department, that is marketing management. Yes, all the people who are working in corporates must know, even though they are not directly involved in marketing, they should know the marketing strategies and marketing management. What is this marketing management? Marketing management comprises of several different sub-areas in the field of marketing, but it is essentially focuses on the use of marketing campaigns, strategies and techniques in order to boost a company's presence in a particular market. Yes, friends, it has been understood that the goal of business lies in the marketplace. Marketing management begins with research and analysis of a certain segment of the population and then continues with orientation and segmentation later. Planning the marketing strategies to use, advertising and building customer relationships. Dear friends, let me come out and tell you what are the philosophies of. Without a doubt, marketing management is a multifaceted concept that anyone attempting to use it should first learn and understand all the essential methods and tools to ensure a successful endeavor. It is so dynamic that every day, every hour, you will find a new product coming into the market, and also we have to know the consumer psychology. In marketing management, if we start with it, the first thing will be the marketing objectives, which will go with the analysis and evaluation and also planning and marketing management. Then you have staffing. Direction, organization, which also has a direction of control and coordination. So let us see how this training will help you. Okay, you will learn the significance of the value of marketing management for your company, which already you know, we are only reinforcing it. Learn the different types of marketing methods employed. Know how to conduct a market research. Gain a good understanding of market orientation and segmentation. Understand the most effectual marketing strategies and know the importance of understanding customer needs and building customer relationships. Know how to make use of online marketing tools and techniques. Learn how to create effective advertising campaigns as well as utilize unconventional marketing tactics. Ongoing research is marketing strategic planning, post-show activities follow-up, then you have exhibits marketing and then exhibits plan execution. So what are the aspects there? Marketing management, you have the importance of marketing, types of marketing, market reach, research, marketing orientation, segmentation, analysis, strategies, marketing mix, understanding customer needs, developing customer relationship, creating effective advertisement campaigns, global marketing, online marketing technique, email marketing tactics and unconventional marketing tactics. Today here we will be understanding the 7 steps of marketing process, which you all know, but we will be just going through again for our reinforcement and also understanding the recharging ourselves. There are 7 steps in marketing process. First is understanding your customer, analyze the market, analyze the competition. That's the most important thing. Research distribution channels, define your marketing mix, analyze the financials, and review and revise. Let us go first, the first step, consumer. These needs and desires need to be looked at. Several important questions must be asked. What are these? What is the need category? Who needs us and why? Who is buying and who is using the product? What is buying process? Is what I am selling a high or a low involvement product? How can I segment market? Now, what is the need category? Who needs us and why? That's the most important aspect. It is essential to answer this question. You have to find out about the need of your product. What other similar products are available and how is their market? Who will buy from you and why should they buy? Now, define the merits of your product and highlight why the consumer can safely change to your product. If you can do that, who is buying and who is using the product, then you have to have the questions to deal with such thing is research about the usage of the product. Buyers are different and users are different. We know that. Housewife might buy what her family needs. Men's clothes might be bought by the women. Children's toys are bought by the women. So all these are the understanding of it. So what is the buying process? Awareness, information, search, evaluative, alertness, purchase, and then evaluate. So in all these things, the buying process goes first is preparing to shop. Then financing. Finding the right broker. Finding a condominium. Making an offer. Negotiating. Closing and moving on. In this process, we have to understand how we have to go about. So, is what I am selling a high or a low involvement product? This is a question which we all have to ask for ourselves. Link product to a high involvement issue. Use involving advertisements. Change the importance of product benefits. Introduce important characteristics to your product. Yes, we have to do all this because these are the four generic ways which we can accomplish in our marketing. How can I segment market? By geographic, demographic, psychographic, and behavior and evaluation. If we know what is the marketing strategy, like consumer behavior, consumer environment, and effect of this cognition, we can understand how we can do. In this, wheel of consumer analysis can be taken. A simple model of the key factors in understanding consumer behavior and guiding marketing strategy. It consists of three parts: effect and cognition, behavior, and the environment. Now, when we talk about all the wheel of consumer analysis, we also understand that this is very dynamic. The elements of wheel change continuously. So, we have to have, it is also a multi-level. These elements can be analyzed at several different levels, like at society level, industry level, marketing, market segment level, or individual level. Or if you can go into a hierarchy. So this consumer level strategies, analysis, a set of stimulus placed in consumers' environment designed to influence their effects, cognition and behavior. Then, what is marketing strategy we need to follow? Marketing strategy should be designed not only to influence consumers but also to be influenced by them. So, a set of stimulus placed in consumers' environment designed to influence their affect, cognition and behavior. What is the next step? Market analysis. Yes, from consumer, now we have to go to market analysis. This includes a review of competition and regulatory environment. Let us see what is the relevant market we should know. Where is the product in its product life cycle, we understand, and what are the key competitive factors in the industry. There are 5 factors like quality, price, advertising, research and development, and service. Of course, we have in the life cycle, product life cycle, we have 4 generic stages. The introduction, that is, what is it? Growth, where can I get it? Maturity, why this one? And decline, how much? So let us see the market analysis. If we go first market analysis, first is the market position. In market position, we have to know market niche, market leader, market follower and market challenger. In all these things, the small part of an existing market is a market niche. So we have to understand all the positions, market position. Now next is market objectives. What are the market objectives? National growth, international growth, ethical objectives, market share, consumer focus, product focus, image, social responsibility, revenue maximization, shareholder value, and overcome competitors. Dear friend, to follow these objectives, we have to get into a market segment. What is market segment? What are the other things which will affect the market segments? Are the age, religion, gender, income level, lifestyles, ethnic grouping, social class, geographical region, family circumstances and behavioristics. When we go into this social class, there can be higher managerial and professional levels to long-term unemployed and never employed. So this is a grouping, general grouping. So the social class can be higher managerial, professional and administrative levels and pensioner, casual workers also and unemployed too. So we have to look into that social grouping. There can be a new grouping. So, and the new groupings also we can. Then we have to understand which segment we have to go. First we have to understand what are the segments, market segments. But now we have to understand which segment we have to choose. Mass markets, multiple segments or single segment. Yeah, in this segment we have to understand it, choose one. Then get into market structure. Market structure, whether it is highly competitive, an imperfect competition is there, oligopoly is there, duopoly is there, or monopoly is there. If you know the structure, pricing strategy, branding, product differentiation, market penetration, market skimming, direct selling. All these are the market structure determines its strategy. Then if you have the market structure, you should know what is the new entrants, who are the buyers, substitutes, suppliers, and most important, who is your rival, with whom it is. Once we know that, we can move on to the step 3. Analyze the competition. Yes. Now we have chosen our market segment and marketplace. Then why we have to understand our competition? Today in this world, that this is the most important thing, is analyzing our competition. The first step preparing in the competition is to determine who your competitors are. And the next one is, you need to gather the information. What you need to know? What markets or market segments your competitors serve? What benefits your competitors offer? Why customers buy from them? And as much as possible about their products or services, pricing and promotion. Gathering information on competitors. Yes, friends, analyzing the competition. How are you going to compete with that company? Then writing the competitive analysis. Outline the competitive environment, then competitive advantage, how it works. Then you can go and have your flag on the mountain of your marketing. Analysis of your company versus the competition. You have to do the SWOT analysis here. What is your company good at and what is the competitor good at? A distributor or a new product development and or advertising? Then who are we in the marketplace? Market size, financial position and historical performance and reputation. Yes, friends, we should know what are our resources versus those of the competitor. People, technology, research, and then sales, cash, trade relations, and manufacturing. All these are core competencies for the competition. What is the market share of the industry player? How does it go about it? How does my product perpetually map against the competitor? Perpetual mapping. How strongly do your clients associate different image statements with your brand more strongly than with the brands of your competitors? If we have to understand a perpetual mapping, we have to know how to draw it. Then by understanding the position of the client brand and the competitive brand, there might be some questions which are need to be addressed. Like, what attributes does the brand own? What attributes do competitors own? Are there gaps in the market that may be filled by the client brand? How should the brand be positioned to both the relevant to the market and differentiated from the competition? Dear friends, how is my product positioned against the competitor is what is to be known. There are some rules, set of rules to follow. Own a word in the consumer's mind and establish one benefit. Positioning begins with the product's name. If you have a unique new product, use a new name. The easiest way to own a word is to be first. Don't stray from your message. Introduce a new brand. Establish a new category. Find an open position in the consumer's mind. Reposition under the leader concept. Stay consistent the positioning you chose. Yes, friends, there are offerings like market needs, organization capability comes as a market space. So now the next step is channels of distribution. What is the channels of distribution? Growing importance of marketing channels is a very important thing. Strategic channel management, marketing channels and sustainable competitive advantage, supply chain management, strategic analysis, alliances, partnerships and networks, the internet and electronic marketing channels, trends in marketing channels, all these things we will be looking into. Three questions should be asked to provide you with a basis for your distribution decision. How can my product reach the consumer? How much do the players in each distribution channel profit? Who holds the power in each distribution channels available? Then let us have the marketing channel strategy in growing very important nowadays. What are the reasons why it is so important? Search for sustainable competitive advantage, growing power of retailers in marketing channels, the need to reduce distribution costs, the increased role and power of technology, the new stress on growth. What is the bottom line? Marketing channel strategy has become critically important for most businesses. Yes, friends, we have to understand the channels of distribution are strategy in market channels. What is the basic strategic questions we have to ask ourselves? What role should distribution play in the firm's overall objectives and strategies? What role should distribution play in the marketing mix? How should the firm's marketing channels be designed to achieve its distribution objectives? What kinds of channel members should be selected to meet the firm's distribution objectives? How can the marketing channel be managed to implement the firm's channel design effectively and efficiently on a continuing basis? So the channels of distribution, which can be degree of consumer satisfaction, product strategy, pricing strategy, promotional strategy, and place channel strategy. There is a customer satisfaction, and company's marketing mix can both be called as degree of customer satisfaction is equal to P1, P2, P3, P4. That's where the P4 comes. Commonly used channel intermediaries to the consumers are wholesalers, distributors, sales representatives, sales forces, and retailers. Yes. What is the classic marketing channel strategies still relevant today? I'm reinforcing it. Dual distribution, exclusive dealing, pull line forcing, price differentiation, price maintenance, refusal to deal, resale restrictions, and tying agreements. Yes, friends. We have to, how much do the players in each distribution channel profit then? Everyone who touches the market takes a cut, which is called margin. Participants in the distribution chain are said to take margin from the manufacturer. The relative power of the channel participants can dictate pricing decisions based on the economies of the channel chosen. Who holds the power in each distribution channels available? The question of channel power is crucial in selecting where to sell. Yes, we should know where to go and sell. Then next comes the most important thing is the market mix. Market mix today, from 4P, it went to 7P, then 9P, then somebody introduced 27P, and our 5H program introduces 30P. Now market mix, especially, if we talk about the 9 mix, 4 mix already we have spoken there, place, price, promotion, people, process, physical environment and product. All the nine are introduced. Marketing mix is one of the most fundamental concepts in marketing management. For attracting consumers and the sales promotion, every manufacturer has to concentrate on these four basic elements like product, pricing, distributed channels and sales promotion techniques. A fair combination of these marketing elements is called market mix. It is the blending of four inputs, four P's, which is from the core of marketing system. This marketing mix is marketing manager's tool for achieving marketing objectiveness or targets. He has to use the four elements of marketing mix in a rational manner to achieve his marketing objectives in terms of volume of sales and consumer support. Yes, dear friends, marketing mix is the combination of four basic elements or ingredients under one head. Product itself is the most important element of marketing mix. Then price, place and promotion are the other supportive elements. Marketing mix indicates an appropriate combination of four P's for achieving market objectives. The four components of marketing mix are also called marketing mix variables or controllable variables. Dear friends, the product, price, promotion and place is the consumer satisfaction. But today the consumer satisfaction is becoming a more challenging way. Consumers are asking so many demands. So there is a different change. The features of marketing mix also are getting changed. So periodical adjustment of variables are necessary nowadays. Marketing manager acts as a mixer of ingredients. Customer is the focus point. The main focus of marketing mix is the customer. His satisfaction and support are important. Variables of marketing mix are for giving more satisfaction and pleasure to consumers. So variables are interrelated. Marketing mix variables are interrelated. Decision in one area affects action in the other areas. An integrated approach is needed while marketing making changes in the marketing mix variables. Yes friends, consumer oriented activity should be. Marketing mix is a consumer oriented activity as its purpose is to give satisfaction and pleasure to consumers. Here the needs of the expectations of consumers are given in a special attention and four P's are adjusted accordingly. Four P's of sellers correspond to four P's of customers. What is that? A product gives you customer solution. Price gives you customer cost. Place gives you customer convenience. Promotion gives you customer communication. Yeah, they both are corresponding P4 to C4. Now if you have to have the elements and ingredients of marketing mix, if we talk about product, there you have quality, features, design, style, brand, packaging, label, services and warranties. Then when we come to place, channels, coverages, locations, inventory, transport. Then comes to promotions, advertising, personal selling, sale promotion, publicity, public and also credit cards. We have to understand public relations also are the displays and then the credit cards. Then we have the price. Pricing strategy, you have to have allowances, payments, credit issues and handling charges. All this becomes the target is the market. So that is a marketing mix. Now when you talk about the product, the style, shape, product line and range, all these include in the variables. Design, color, quality and other physical features of a product. Packaging and labeling of the product. Branding and trademark given to the product. Product innovation and product services. So we have to understand the distribution channel as a place. There are types of intermediary available for distribution, distribution marketing available for distribution, and transportation, warehousing, inventory, control of market, making the product available to consumer easily and economically. Then promotions, which we have already spoken, is the promotion mix includes advertising and publicity of the product. Personal selling techniques, sales promotion measures introduced at different levels, public relations techniques used for keeping cordial relationships with dealers and consumers, and display of goods for sales promotion. Dear friends, the price, as we already said, will include the variables as pricing policies, discounts and concessions, capturing the market, terms of credit sales, terms of delivery, and pricing strategies selected and used. So when we look into all the four P's, there are seven P's of marketing also. The four P's and seven P's help the concept to take it. What are the seven P's? Product, price, place, promotion, then people, process, and physical evidence. Then it comes the nine P's. Here, the product, purpose, performance, profile, potential, place, price, promotion, and position. Dear friends, as we talk about the seven P's, nine P's, and social media has come out with so many things, today people talk about 27 P's. What are the 27 P's? Product, price, promotion, place are already there. People, process, physical evidence is there. Purpose, purchaser, push and pull, personal relationship, positioning, packaging, persuasion, performance, profitable, proactive, pull together, perform, permission, pain, pleasure, periodic, persistent, partner, psychology, and perception. These are 27 P's. Five types added, three more P's, like practice, fabulous, that is nourishment, specificate to give peace to, we being the health aspect needs to be taken. That's why these three P's are also added. So developing a solid marketing strategy for your business. How do you do it? We have 8 steps to do this business. Like define your vision and goals. Then understand your ideal client and competitor. Develop your core message. Identify your brand, determine marketing strategy and budget, identify activities for each of your strategy, create your sales tools to support the tactics, and of course, execute, track and measure the results. All the 8 steps need to develop a solid marketing strategy for your own business. So marketing plan process also defines this vision and goals. So SMART, your goals need to be SMART. SMART means what? Specific, measurable, achievable, relevant and time-based. When you understand your ideal client and competitor, highlight why you are different and what value you offer to your clients. When you develop your core message, a good core message projects what makes you unique and a benefit to your ideal client. Dear friends, when you are identifying your brand should fit your personality and help get you noticed. And when you are determining marketing strategy and budget, you should have the internet, including social media. You have to. Advertising, direct marketing, public relations, events, work of mouth and strategic alliances. Identify the activities of each strategy which can be executed regularly and effectively and are affordable. Create your sales tools to support the tactics. That's where we said business cards, brochures, a website or a blog, white papers, testimonials or promotional items. Here we say is marketing execution is plan, execute, track and measure. Dear friends, SMS of marketing planning. You should know how to plan your market. And this marketing is a market segment research, product development, customer satisfaction, brand marketing, pricing strategy, demand forecasting, product portfolio strategy, and product life cycle. When you have this support, you have to go for the approach and the philosophy. So there you can understand, analyze and reporting of your. So it is a process of marketing where you have to understand it. Email marketing is not simply sending out emails to multiple addresses. Marketers should understand how to use the process. Internet marketing helps you plan, design and develop promotion and publicity and monitor performance and success. Analyze of financial statement. The use of financial ratios, analyzing liquidity, activity, debt, profitability and ratio analysis. A complete ratio analysis should be taken. The use of financial ratios are very important. Same thing, interested parties. Three sets of parties are interested in ratio analysis. Shareholders, creditors and management. Types, cross-sectional and time series analysis. These are the types of ratio comparison. Then you have words of caution regarding ratio analysis. A single ratio rarely tells enough to make a sound judgment. So financial statements used in ratio analysis must be from similar points in time. Then groups of financial ratios. Liquidity, activity, debt and profitability. Analyzing liquidity, analyzing activity and activity measures like inventory turnover, average collection period, average payment period, fixed asset turnover and total asset turnover. All these are very important. When you are measuring the debt, degree of indebtedness, ability to serve debts, both have to be taken care of. Dear friends, debt measures like debt ratio, debt equity ratio, times interest earned ratio, fixed payment coverage ratio, all are very important measures. And when you are talking about analyzing profitability, you have to take care of gross profit margin, operating profit margin, net profit margin, return on total assets, return on equity, earnings per share and price earnings ratio. Yes friends, a complete ratio analysis is done with the dew point system. And this dew point system analysis is a profitable measure, an efficient measure, and a leverage measure. All the three components are looked into. When we summarize all these ratios, we understand that comparisons to the firm itself over time are also made. Comparisons are made to industry standards, an approach that will all have the aspects of the firm activities to isolate key areas of concern. So the next step is financial analysis of common stocks. This is the sixth step. Of course, financial analysis and financial stocks all are the sixth step. Then you get how to analyze the financial analysis, the activity of providing inputs to the portfolio management process. Then you have the professional financial analysis organizations. Reasons for financial analysis. There are two reasons: to determine certain securities characteristics, to attempt to identify mispriced securities. And when we talk about this, technical analysis also takes place. This is a form of security analysis that attempts to forecast price changes based on historical price and volume trends. Dear friends, when we do this technical analysis, we also look into momentum and constraint strategies, moving average and trading range breakout strategies. Now, moving average and trading range breakout strategies have a very high and low prices for past 200 trading days are identified. We have to look into that, not the old pricing. And then there is a fundamental analysis, top-down, bottom-up, and top-down approach. It will attempt to forecast the economic activity, industry performance, and firm's performance. And top-down approach attempts to estimate prospects in the firm, industry, and economy. Now, when we talk about all these analyses, the integral part of the fundamental analysis is it helps the analyst understand a firm's current condition, where it is headed, what factors affect us, how the factors affect us. Then review of account statements, the balance sheet, the income statement, and the statement of cash flows. When you look into all these things, you have to use a ratio tool. The ratio analysis are types like in the different types are internal liquidity, operating performance, risk analysis, and growth analysis. All these will work better if you have review, which is the seventh step. In a review, you have to have update, plan, and implement. How it is? For most professional service firms, creating a marketing system is not a one-time project with a definite begin and end point. Rather, it is an iterative process where we work on adding a new component to the system, improve an existing piece, and perhaps remove a component that is not performing. Yes, friends, this need for an iterative process is driven by several factors like the complexity of creating the system, the need to change and adapt, reality that is more often than not, the marketing function is being performed by someone for whom marketing is just one of the many hats they wear. So one of the essential keys to success in managing an iterative process is to have a well-defined review process in place. Whether you are solely responsible for marketing or work as part of the team, a strong review process will help you stay on track with your big picture goals while you wrestle with the challenges of implementing tactics on a day-to-day basis. Dear friend, the use of to keep marketing review sessions useful and efficient. The first is to hold review sessions on a fairly frequent basis. If you are just getting started, do them monthly. Quarterly is better than not doing them at all, but they tend to run long and wander a bit. The second tactic is to follow a four-step process in these sessions, which we already spoke. A combination of following the same process and do it on a regular basis makes for an efficient and effective marketing review process. The four steps, like in the review, are assumptions and the lesson learned. The first is the outline, a review. Then you have update. Once you have reviewed, you update. In this phase, you do the marketing materials, milestones, budget, metrics, and our marketing calendars. Then you have plan. During the plan phase, we get ready for the next iteration. We create and assign milestones, identify resource needs, map out timelines. Then we have to have implement, do marketing again. Then launch your new product. Yes. Now, doing this with the whole process of marketing takes place. Dear friend, let us do a small exercise of using positive and negative chart organizers. Please illustrate the effects of e-marketing and also the process in e-marketing. So I request you to go with it. You can take a new product, think of a new product and start giving it. You can do it in your virtual teams. Thank you. Welcome, friends. Today we will be dealing with effective meeting management. Yes, even meeting management is a skill to be conducted and to be followed. Every organization holds meetings to discuss important matters. While emails and memos help enhance communication between and among managers and employees, meetings are still considered the best means to discuss pressing issues. Dear friend, even though every organization holds meetings, the problem is that half the time meetings are not really productive, thereby wasting time and resources. Effective meeting management is crucial if you want to carry out your agenda efficiently and achieve the desired outcome for the meeting. Facilitators and managers should know how to direct the meeting in such a way that everyone will be able to contribute to make the business gathering a success. Meeting management training will help you learn how to conduct meetings. This guide will provide you with all the necessary information on how to plan, prepare, and conduct meetings. All these things are given in the module. It is not an easy responsibility, but if done correctly, you will surely gain the respect for your superiors and employees. Dear friends, let us understand what we are going to do, the importance of meetings, types of meetings, bad meetings and good meetings, how to plan, prepare, and the agenda for the meeting, the know-how of what is the outcome of every meeting, to manage time efficiently during the meetings, gain knowledge and assign roles and responsibilities acquire invaluable tips and to hold meetings, and also know how on avoid resistance and arguments during the meetings. There are many aspects. The aspects will be why meetings are important, why meetings, types and objectives of meetings, meeting planning, meeting agenda, meeting management and optimization, preparation, time management, meetings follow-up, meeting participants, roles and responsibilities, advantages of meetings, disadvantages of meetings, how to control effective meetings, how to avoid arguments during meetings, meeting tips for managers and meeting tips for team members. All these aspects we will cover. Let us understand the meeting strategy, meeting management. It's a plan, source, manage and measure. The objectives of this management is to identify the components of good meeting, the debate the roles of directors and office at meeting, the review the basic rules of parliamentary meeting procedures, to explore two options for decision making. Dear friend, what is management meeting and why it is important? What happens when there is good meeting management? Someone directs the meeting, the necessary people are there, the important topics will get covered, everyone has his or her say, personal conflicts are set aside, progress is made, arguments are made and agreements may be reached. Yes, what happens when there is not good meeting management? The right people may not be at the meeting. I am too busy, they will say. We can do that after the corn is planted. We tried them before and they did not work. Meetings are a waste of time. All these things are bad meeting management. There may be no direction, so important topics may not be covered. People may not speak or feel heard. Personal conflicts may interfere. Nothing may get along. So we should need justice and courtesy to all, one thing at a time, the rule of the majority and the rights of the minority. This is the main core of a meeting management. So let us see what are the good meeting management strategies. Set the stage, be prepared, select a coordinator or a facilitator, have the necessary people there, have an agenda. At the meeting, use the facilitator to follow the agenda, engage everyone, manage conflict and summarize. After the meeting, send out notes and reminder of next meeting. Dear friends, there are good meetings, we said. In good meetings, people nod in agreement. In poor meetings, people just nod. Elements of good meetings are planning and preparation, efficient disposal of business, open participation with adherence to the rules and effective follow-up. So how do we prepare to ensure access to documents and materials, attention to meeting environment and follow through on discussions? What items we need? Meeting minutes of the previous meeting, copies of reports and correspondence. When we do, we also know the business process management life cycle to be brought into the management. That is, we need to design, modeling, execution, monitoring and optimization. What is the director's responsibility? Awareness of topics, context and stakeholders' positions, review of documents prior to meeting, preparation for debate and decision making. Dear friends, how does the facilitator manage the meeting? He said we should have a coordinator or a facilitator. We should have pre-meeting, because each one of you are the facilitators of the meeting. And if you are the facilitator, you should look into pre-meeting. At the meeting, what should be done? Ground rules. Go through the agenda. Take notes. Keep the process moving and on track. Help resolve conflicts constructively. At the end of the meeting, verbally summarize. Follow up with written summary. Thank everyone coming. Meeting environment. Ensure that a bright room with adequate lighting, a comfortable heating level or AC level, good air circulation, a good seating arrangement, and the early opening of the room. Now, we have to know the agenda. Call to order. Review and approval of agenda. Reading and adaptation of minutes. Business arising from minutes. And treasurer's report. Correspondence. Reports from committees. New business. Date and time of next meeting. And adjournment. Dear friend, what is the role of the agenda? We are speaking about the agenda, but the role, it provides a map, a trial guide. Never get into a meeting without an agenda. Following it allows the family can see that the meeting has been productive. People are more willing to come to meetings that are productive, civil, short, and business-like. What is a new business? Add policy and strategic issues to the agenda before circulation. List motion to be debated. Role of the chair. Ensure orderly debate and opportunity for participation. Remain impartial during the debate. Vacate the chair when presenting personal viewpoints. Use a gavel to keep order. If in doubt, consult the secretary's notes. Meeting process. Role of the secretary. Keep records of procedures. Produce minutes summarizing discussions. Maintain copies of bylaws, policies, and previous minutes. Maintain correspondence. Oversee use of corporation seal. Notify participants of meeting. Then minute taking, a very important procedure. Minutes are the official record of the proceedings. Minutes must include the time, date, place, and names of the attendees, and the exact wordings of motions, naming over and seconder. Minutes maintain the individual's confidentiality. Official opposition to the course of action must be recorded. Minutes are adopted and signed off at the following meeting. Use communication skills that will help facilitate a positive meeting. Yes, speaking and feeling heard, taking turns, using I statements, respect is the most important thing, active listening, content, emotion. Both should be, and positive participation. Conflict can result in communication breakdown. What is going on? Feeling unheard and unimportant, experiencing a lack of respect, feeling at a disadvantage, feeling overwhelmed, feeling powerless, questioning ability or professionalism, questioning one's commitment, questioning integrity, fear, grief, and loss. Using active listening. Active listening helps people to feel understood and is a useful way of identifying potential misunderstanding before they have the chance to mushroom into bigger conflicts. Proactive way to manage emotional situations, facilitates discussion by conveying respect. The listener reflects the content and the emotion. What is positive participation? Always comes and is prepared. Speaks and listens at appropriate times. Does not talk about others afterwards. Is polite and respectful. May be emotional. Is willing to address even difficult issues. Raise appropriate issues. Brings necessary information. Then how to run an effective meeting? Preliminary thoughts should be there. Who likes a meeting? Without a clearly defined agenda that seems to drag on forever, that rambles from topic to topic, that ends without any apparent result. These types of meetings are frustrating, a waste of time and waste of one's most valuable resources of any organization, that is the time. What is the outline? Meeting management, a leadership responsibility. Why effective meetings? Elements of an effective meeting are types of meeting, the meeting, additional thought. All these should be outlined. The meeting. Before the meeting, we should have agenda, group dynamics, and personality types. During the meeting, parliamentary procedures, meeting room arrangements, roles, chair, secretary, members in general, and how to deal with disruptive members. Then after the meeting, we should know how we have to do the outcome of the meeting to be addressed. Meeting management and leadership responsibility. Many people are promoted, elevated, or elected into leadership positions without receiving any formal training or education on how to run an effective meeting. Why effective meetings? Time a crucial resource. Opportunity cost. So we have to know how an effective meeting can take place. Characteristics of negative meetings. Yes, when we know the characteristics of negative meetings, we will know what is a positive meeting. 83% drift from the subject. 77% poor preparation. 74% questionable effectiveness. 68% lack of listening. 62% verbose participants. 60% length. 51% lack of participation. Yes, friends, all these are the negative meetings. Then what are the effective meetings? What people are looking for in effective meetings? 88% participation, 66% feel define the meeting's purpose, 62% address each item on the agenda, 59% assign follow-up action, 47% record discussions, 46% invite essential personnel, and 36% publish an agenda. And effective meetings all over the world, it takes place. Elements of an effective meeting. Effective meeting does not happen just. Require deliberate planning. Must be conducted in an effective and efficient manner. Responsibility of the leader. What are the types of meetings? Formal or informal? With agenda, rules of procedure, minutes are casual and relaxed structure but nothing written. Planning. To prepare or evaluate a plan. To seek information. Reporting. Progress to date. Providing information or status reporting. Administrative. Regular staff meetings, monthly executive committee meetings. Then decision meetings, brainstorming meetings, combination meetings. So before the meeting, define the purpose of the meeting first. Identify the participants. Every invitee should have a role. Identify a recorder or a secretary. Prepare an agenda in advance of the meeting. Communicate the intent of each agenda item using labels such as action, information, or identify estimate of the time allocated to the agenda item. Prepare or identify background information. Assign responsibilities for agenda items and communicate to those responsible. Publish the agenda and identify background information to be reviewed. Plan for breaks, lunch, coffee, etc. Think through the conduct of the meeting. Use a trusted member of your staff or deputy. Consider logistics. Room, layout, seating, distraction, support items, projector, whiteboard, pens, bell-shaped agenda. Purpose of the bell-shaped agenda is to structure events around the group's energy and attention. The first few items help the meeting participants to work as a group on easy items before they tackle more difficult items. Dear friends, in the bell-shaped agenda, the first item should be welcome, second, minutes, third, announcement, non-controversial, short, example, upcoming events. Then item 4 should be easy item. More than one item may be included in this section but should not be controversial. Then hardest item. Why in the middle? Attendance. Latecomers have arrived and early leavers have not left. Attention. Focused on meeting but this time not yet concerned with the next appointment. Then for discussion only. Will often be presented as item, hardest item at subsequent meeting for vote or discussion. Easiest item, end of this meeting is the beginning of next meeting. End or positive note of agreement and disagreement or encouragement. Good time for member recognition. During the meeting, arrive early, arrange the room if necessary, know how to control the lighting and temperature in the room, distribute handouts, begin on time, introduce members if not familiar, introduce visitors, establish ground rules if necessary, run the meeting, control interruptions, ask that cell phones and pagers be turned off, identify and record reserves, assigned responsibilities for follow-up action, registry, end on time. Thank participants for their input and reinforce the importance of outcome on the organization. Dear friends, meeting room is very important. Space matters. Members must be able to easily see one another. Room should be comfortable temperature. Adequate space for planners, notebooks or laptops. People should be able to hear the discussion easily. If it is a large room, the meeting facilitator should consider standing. So you can understand how a meeting place should be. Meeting room arrangements. Theater style, U-shaped style or circular style. You can take any one of the styles. A theater style will lead. The leader has great power by position. Participation and interruption by audience is limited. U-shaped style. Equality of membership. No doubt who the leader is. Good visibility for visual aids. Circular style. Democratic equally is stressed. Great visibility by participants, obvious body language, excellent participation. Member roles, the chair. Prepare for the meeting. Appoint secretary or minute taker if there is not a regular. If you are the chairperson of the meeting, you should look into all these aspects. Conduct and control the meeting. Watch timing or assign someone to this responsibility. ensure all have an equal opportunity to speak, adjudicate as and when necessary, effect compromise on occasion. Dear friend, close each item with ensure action is clear by whom and by when. Check that the minutes are produced accurately and in timely manner. Member roles, the secretary, ensure agenda and relevant papers are distributed in time with date, time and place of meeting. Prepare and book the meeting space. Have background papers and information for the chair. Carry a copy of the constitution, rules of procedure and previous minutes. Record names and attendees and apologies for absence. Check quorum. Take notes of what is said and decided. Minimum necessary. Mixture of memory and full of transcript. Amount of detail dependent and on nature and purpose of meeting. Must be enough to enable accurate minutes. Essential to have gist of discussions, exact words of proposals, names of those promising and proposing and seconding, names of those responsible for future actions. Dear friends, write the minutes preferably as soon as possible. Members in general, people often react to the people, not to their ideas. Chair must stress that effectiveness, disregard for personal or department allegiance, self-perception. Some see themselves as elder statesman, joker, voice of reason. So group building rules should be followed. The initiator, the opinion giver or the elaborator. If you are an initiator, suggest new different ideas and approaches. If you are an opinion giver, state pertinent beliefs about the discussion or other suggestion. But if you are an elaborator, build on suggestions made by others. So you all have to know, each one, how to maintain your role. Tension reliever, some of you can play up, someone can play up as a compromiser, the clarifier, the tester, summarizer, harmonizer, encourager, or gatekeeper. These are supportive roles in the meeting. There can be a disruptive role too, like you are an argumenter, aggressor, blocker, wild winner, and recognized seeker, topic jumper, dominator, special leader, and playboy, or self-confuser, and devil's advocate. All these are disruptive roles. Don't play this. Don't ever take up these roles at all in a meeting, not a statement like. There can be some stereotypes too. That stereotype, like sleeper, destroyer, rationalist, trapper, know-all, thinker, or chatterbox. All of you, some of them are stereotypes. Change from meeting to meeting, your role should change. And don't be casted as stereotyper. How to deal with the disruptive members? Make sure that all meeting participants understand their responsibilities. All members were invited to the meeting for a reason. All members should feel free to contribute. Members who are silent begin meetings by engaging every member of the group. Consider breaking larger group into smaller group to develop inputs. How to deal with the disruptive members? Members who are vocally dominant, redirect discussion to other members. Members who are negative, probe the negativity to validate concerns. Redirect discussions to other members. After the meeting, publish the minutes promptly, identify responsibilities for action items, assess the meeting. Dear friend, additional thoughts on the meeting is, don't read to the group. Place more emphasis on processing information than on giving information. A meeting is a place to discuss an issue to assure meeting agreement or full understanding. Everyone contributes to a meeting success. Everyone must do their part. When possible, make sure the right people are at the right meeting. If the material covered is not relevant to some people, arrange to have them excused from the portion of the meeting. Make sure all meeting participants understand their responsibility. Dear friends, balance participation. Meetings will have people who are silent, vocally dominant, or negative. The facilitator or a chairperson, as well as members of the group, can redirect this unproductive behavior. Dear friends, allow time for process of group development. Checking of agenda items in a rapid fire process is not always productive. It may move the meeting along more quickly, but may leave you wonder what happened when it occurred. So you should understand. Let us have a final thought what we should do. Praise, praise, praise. Yes, praise people twice as much as you criticize. Never let any good deed or action go unheard in the group. Say thank you publicly in every meeting. Recognize the value of people's contributions at the meeting or within the meeting. Then plan. That's the most important thing. Meeting design is the number one mechanism for effective meeting. For each agenda item, make sure the group is clear about the goals, processes, and functions. Never attempt to compose, draft, or edit a report or document in committee. Last word, dear friends. The techniques described can be applied to any type of meeting you encounter. Consider compiling your own list of successful techniques based on specific meetings. Effective meetings are the result of deliberate meetings. Before we go to tutorials, I would like you to go through, refer how to write an effective agenda topic, rules and simplified rules. It is there in the e-library along with the module. There is an e-book and e-library. After that, prepare an agenda for the meeting. Use the format, create a meeting agenda. Now, the format is given here. Create a meeting agenda, which you can have meeting starting time, meeting location, topic headings, include some topic details for each heading, indicate the time each topic is expected to last, indicate which meeting participants are expected to be in the meeting. An agenda, please work it out. Opening remarks, membership report, all the new member program introduction, intramural report, financial report, status of budget, house bill status, rush report, status of current efforts, status of next term plans, internal, external, and if you have a guest speaker. So prepare an agenda, a proper agenda, and send it to your team leader, and the leader will make a final agenda and send it to the HR department. Thank you, friends. Welcome, friends. Today, we will discuss about task management. In any aspect of our lives, We are faced with multiple tasks every day. Dear friends, sometimes we experience headaches just by figuring out which task to tackle first, especially if we cannot seem to correctly determine which ones are more important than others. At home, we deal with such problems and even end up in arguments or quarrels with our loved ones because of our inability to get things done. In the workplace, this becomes an even bigger problem because we have deadlines to meet and a business to take care of. If we are unable to finish our task on time, we could be wasting a lot of company's resources. Yes, and when we were doing the resource allocation itself, we have made it very clear that we need to allocate our resources like time, money, materials, knowledge, and human resources in a proper way so that we don't mingle with the work. Task is the most important thing there, and the task management. As a result, we become less productive, leaving us frustrated and disappointed. Not to mention, the people we work for and work with will also feel the same way about us and about our work. As much as possible, we want to complete every task or piece of assignment given to us and still provide quality results. Being able to do this on a consistent basis will help prove our potentials and capabilities, and this will leave an indelible mark on our superiors, colleagues, and subordinates, and such impression will ultimately help us climb the echelons of success. That's why in olden days, mostly North India, in Hindi they say, jo kal karna hai kaam aaj karo, jo aaj karna hai ab karo, means whatever you have to do tomorrow, do it today, and whatever you have to do today, do it just now, immediately. So when you have a task, you should plan it and work it out so that, and there should not be any procrastination in task achievement. The aspects in this task management is the importance of task management, principles, aspects, life cycles, and we have to create a plan how to manage tasks efficiently, task follows up, task and productivity, prioritizing our tasks, and project leaders, team groups, personal task management, and online task tools. Dear friends, we have to understand then what is this task management in business. Business executives are faced with an armload of tasks every day. Every day when we start for the office from home, if you are not driving, if you are sitting at the back seat, just think of the task and make it that the moment you enter your office, what all you have to do. Go and put it, or get into the office early in the morning, as soon as you sit in your chair, write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The best is the previous day. You write it and put it on the table and go, so that in the morning there is no need for you to hurry worry, you will know what you have to do. Part of their key responsibility is being able to manage the tasks assigned to them effectively and efficiently so as to maximize productivity among themselves as well as of their subordinates. Dear friends, what is task management? Task management is defined as a process of handling every aspect of a given task or series of tasks in order to achieve the goals set by you your superiors or the company you work for. This involves various processes such as planning, testing, documentation, and reporting. The entire process would vary in complexity from easy to difficult, although its foundation remains the same. Keeping focus on time, you have to know what are your priorities, people, and costs. If you look into all these things, you will be advantageous. Then what are these advantages? We are talking about task management. When you utilize task management in every endeavor, you'll be able to benefit from it. How do we get increased productivity in the organization? Multitasking is made possible without compromising quality. Everyone will be aligned in terms of knowing what needs to be done to achieve a common goal in every task, as well as the overall goals of the company. Skills required of a task manager. To become an effectual task manager, there are some skills which we should know and that an executive must possess. The good news is that if you do not have some of these skills, you cannot still work to develop them. You can. Why not? Anytime we can develop. You know you have all this, but still we are reinforcing it. Good communication skills, execution skills, time management, and people skills. On the overall, task management is rendered important in the job of every executive because it helps you and your company in achieving the goals you have set. Your chances of success is always higher when you utilize the principles, aspects, and guidelines involved in task management. As you all are the leaders, team leaders, and also you are going to be the trainer, you have to understand to explain to the workforce how they have to manage the task. Task management is deemed very important among executives because it helps them become more productive. It reduces the time allotted for setting priorities, encourages us to make use of the art of delegation, and enables us to differentiate from the four kinds of individual tasks, which are urgent and important, not urgent but important, urgent but not important, not urgent and not important. So we have to keep in mind urgent and important as the first one. You prioritize your making a to-do list. To-do list will help you. A very good thing about making a to-do list is that you can clear your mind of unnecessary worries brought about by thinking of how you can get everything done on time. Delegation to increase productivity. Delegation is one of the ways you can implement task management, and this you need to understand and accept. How do you delegate them? First, you need to choose the kind of tasks you can pass on to someone else. Usually, it is best to delegate those which are routine work as well as those that are not in your competency. Then select a person you think is capable of doing the work based on skills and abilities as well as the personality and attitude of the person. Give clear instructions. Make sure they understand completely the goals you wish to achieve for the task. Of course, do not forget to mention the deadline. Dear friends, knowing the difference between the kinds of tasks, we should start working. Urgent tasks are those that need to be addressed immediately and these may include answering emails and phone calls. Important tasks, on the other hand, may not always be urgent, but it could be a big impact on your company or business. This includes planning for a management presentation, providing a solution to a customer's issue, or building good relationship with other people in your company or with clients. So what we have to learn? Learning the skills of prioritizing, delegation, differentiation, tasks that need to be done and those that are not necessary, or what make task management important. Task management principles today are inbox, next, then tomorrow, scheduled, someday, projects, completed, trash. All these are principles. Start in the morning and what to be done at what time. So, first principles of these are plan, control, proactive, monitor, teamwork, pay attention, document everything. You need to document everything. Why task management principles? Among the reasons why we use the task management principles are: serve as guide, help us understand how to manage the task given, reduce incidents of failure. Managerial aspects of task management. The managerial aspects of task management start with determining the scope of the task given. It is necessary for you to set the timeline, which should include when the task will start, when it will evaluate, when it will be completed. Dear friends, behavior aspects of task management need to be taken care of. In any task management, there is always the behavioral aspect of the people involved in a particular task. To handle organizational human behavior revolving around culture of the organization, motivational approaches, and conflict management. What are the other aspects of task management then? Technology plays a vital role in today's business. A software program designed for task management is able to perform many functions like create tasks, visualize tasks, sends notifications, delegates work to others, provides reports, prepares contingency measures. A task management software can also help monitor performance of people involved in a task. The basic task life cycle. That is, its life cycle commences the moment a task comes on your way and ends when it has been abandoned. There are four phases of the cycle. They are open, in progress, review, and closed. It can be a four-petaled flower. Let us think of it. You open it from one petal, see that it progresses, then review it and close it. What are the traps of the task life cycle? A common mistake that a task manager and the members of his team make a putting on hold the feeling of gratification until such time the task is rendered complete. As a result, you and your team will feel unmotivated and might eventually feel bored. Cramming may be effective at giving us an adrenaline rush, but it can also mean delivering unsatisfactory results. Yes, friends, you have to need for focus. A task can be an hour, a day, a week, a month, or even a year to finish, depending on the scope, size, and requirements involved. If you lack focus, the chances of you getting sidetracked will be significantly high, and this is something you do not want to happen. Don't procrastinate and wait because you have a time and you go on doing the last moment. How to create a task management plan? Task management is all about managing your task properly in an efficient manner. The activities that are part of this process range from planning, setting priorities, checking needed resources, testing, documentation, and reporting of outcomes. Since we are often presented with rumors, tasks daily, it is important that you not only know what are involved in task management, but that you should also come up with a plan to help you. Understanding a task management plan. A task management plan is the answer if you aim to deal with your day-to-day tasks successfully. A task management plan will ensure that you will be able to go about your tasks smoothly because it helps you become organized and prepared for the scope of work you are about to undertake. Dear friends, there are many steps in task management plan. The first is set the goals. Create a to-do list. Include a system for scheduling. Review and create backup plans. Relay the plan for others. Yes, we have to do it. Factors to be considered in task management is time, human resources, and budget. The guidelines that we use to be efficient in managing our tasks, list down your day-to-day activities. Learn to say no to those that are not necessary in completing your tasks. Delegate. Tips to manage tasks efficiently. Keep a clean working environment. Take a break. Stay away from distractions. Keep the lights on. Sort out all the things you need to sort out. Efficiently using the principles are, you must have heard about Pareto principle, otherwise referred to as the 80-20 rule. Yeah, you'd have definitely understood the 80-20 rule. What is 80-20 rule? Actually, it is a Pareto principle. It states that 80% of the results are produced by 20% of the effort. This is the best way. If you put 20% of effort, you can achieve 80% of results. How to do it? Task follow-ups. A lot of factors can affect one's efficiency as well as the success of every task, and if we are not careful, we might just forget and overlook central points in our task. That is why there is always the need to make follow-ups. There are various ways you can do this as indicated, like follow through email, follow through phone call, or other ways of follow-up. Leaving voicemail messages, posting sticky notes on the person's desk. Probably the best means to make a follow-up is to simply set a time to meet with the person. A follow-up is an effective way to keep everyone working towards a common goal. Dear friend, task management and productivity. Productivity is defined as the value of one's output divided by time, which could be further subdivided into the output hourly or daily. One of the very essential ways to ensure high productivity is to know how to manage tasks. The role of task management. In order for anyone to be productive, you need to be able to finish a lot of things in a less amount of time. Task management and productivity are interrelated. The idea is that one is the cause and the other is the effect. Productivity optimization through task management. Here are some ways you can increase productivity through task management. Keeping a to-do list. Work on difficult tasks in the morning. getting your workplace organized, be more efficient. Dear friends, productivity killers. What are these? This procrastination, lack of planning, and multitasking. All these are productivity killers. Multitasking, we should be oriented for multitasking. You can't be obsessed for multitasking. Yeah, it is a disease. Multitasking obsession is a disease. Multitasking orientation is a skill. So the quality needs to be kept when we are doing the task. Six Sigma, as we have understood, ISO. So learn all the enterprise skills to keep the quality. How to prioritize your tasks? Make decisions when your mind is fresh and alert. Know how to do the interruptions. Avoid worrying about things you have no control over. There are benefits of task management for project leaders. Since project leaders are considered the prime movers of any team, being able to manage the different tasks needed to complete a project is deemed important. Here are some of the benefits we can reap out, like improved communication, cost effectiveness, better team management. Dear friends, there are three steps in utilizing task management for teams. The first thing you need to do is to plan and schedule the tasks that need to be done. If you are the team leader, you should see to it that each given assignment gets done. To measure the team's performance, it is necessary to make and send out reports. Yes, friends, a guide to managing your personal tasks. Managing personal tasks is very similar to what you do at work, and this is because it revolves around the same principles: consistency, efficiency, and discipline. Here are some guidelines that you can use them. Make a list of everything you need to do. Break down big tasks into smaller, simpler ones. Know the priority. Always keep track of your to-do list. How to use some smartphone, pocket PC, or Palm to manage your tasks. Key principles put it: doing mind sweep, keeping it bite-sized, managing categories, priority, using the 2-minute rule, little tips and tricks, closing thoughts. All these things can be used for your task management. Then create a group, a free group, in minutes, and share calendars, tasks, news, files, and a lot more. Various online task management tools. Google To-Do List, Remember the Milk, the Online CEO, and Doodle-Lado. Doodle-Do is the most important aspect. The Online CEO will help you. So, keep the clock going. No procrastination, and tasks, the important and urgent ones, are the most important things. So let us do a small tutorial, friends. Use time order and write about your task for the new project you are going to handle. Take up a new project and put the time order chart and fill the time order chart and send it to the department. Thank you. Welcome, friends. Today, let us talk about teamwork. We have been talking about team leader, but now we have to know how this teamwork takes place. What is teamwork? Yogi Berra, she said, when you are part of a team, you stand up for your teammates. Your loyalty is to them. You protect them through good and bad because they had to do the same for you. Yes, you had to work for thieves. Now, how we have to work for thieves? What is a team? A team is a collection of individuals, each with his or her own expertise, brought together to a benefit of a common goal. Teams are often comprised of people who do not know each other and who must work to develop productive working relationship despite personal differences and cultural practices. Dear friends, there are a lot of benefits for team. What are those benefits? How can we say that individually we cannot achieve, but as a team we can achieve? Yes, we can achieve as a team. Before we discuss about the benefits, I would like to tell you a small story here, which you would already learnt it when you are very young. A father, a farmer, had 4 children. And one day he called and he said, "You all should work in the farmlands." They did not listen. He went on telling them. They did not listen. Then one day he was not feeling well. He was on the bed. He called all the 4 of them. He said, "I called all of you together to do the work you were not doing. So what you can do is take each bit of the land, 4 of you, do yourself. Now I cannot do anything." So he gave the land to them in bits and pieces and said, "Come on, go ahead and do work." They were not able to do. Everybody, they have to pose. Each one of them are not good at any of the work. They did not succeed. One day, all the 4 came to the father and said, "How you are able to be successful and we are not successful? Dad, please tell us." He says, "Individually I started, but today we cannot do individually everything. We need a team. We need to work together." Then he said, "Okay, go, each one of you bring one stick." They brought the sticks. They gave. He said, "Break the sticks." They just broke it. Then he said, "Go and bring another stick." They went and brought another stick. He tied all the 4 sticks together as one bunch and gave them to break it. None of them were able to break it. Then, of course, we say, unity is the best policy. United we stand, divided we fall. But there, he was telling them to work unitedly as a team. Sports, we have teams. Everywhere we have teams. Working in team will be more beneficial. Individuals can work successfully, but they have teams to work and join the team. That work will be much better. With lot of teams we work. Of course, we have problems with the team. That is a different. That's why teamwork, as teamwork, it's a very good thing. So let us see. We try to. For years together, I tried to get into a team and start working. But I see many of them don't want to come together. Then you will be forced to work individually. But though I worked individually many things, I always prefer a teamwork. Because working in team, only we will get good results. So what are the benefits? Shared workloads, chances for leadership and personal satisfaction, sense of belonging to a successful process, ability to accomplish more than if work done independently. So developing a team. In one of the international conferences, when I was hearing our past president, Dr. Abdul Kalam, he was mentioning India when they lived in joint families, there was a good teamwork. Today, nobody is living in a joint family. So even outside, we see they are not able to come together and work in teams. So joint family was making people to come together and work as teams, because they always understood that there is a leader at home and others have to work in a team to set right the goals. But once joint family has gone, the team spirit of work is also reduced. So he pleaded, why don't you all come together again as a joint family system in the work culture? Yes, we should develop a team. Now have team members come together to identify the team's mission. What does the team have to do? How will the team accomplish the task? What information is needed? What resources are available? Dear friend, the team's mission, design processes. You have to understand this. Developing a team, have team members establish group norms, develop guidelines, protocols or rules, establish them by the team through senses, regulate proper and acceptable behavior by and between team members, commit to agreement to follow these rules. No design decision will be acted on or before direction with and consensus without the consensus of the team members. You should take the consensus of team members. So how is the team group norms, establishing a group norm? Create a list of norms by brainstorming with teammates. Analyze each norm and discuss its impact on the team and the overall goal. Identify key norms that everyone can come to senses. Establish consequences if norms are broken. Typical group norms. Input from all team members, team meeting schedules and project timelines, communication protocols, conflict resolution protocols. A copy of the established norms must be provided to each team member. Dear friends, develop a team. Identify team members' strengths and weaknesses. Have team members list their individual talents, skills, and limitations. Identify job responsibilities. Remember, each team member's strengths are a support mechanism for the order or other team members and members' weaknesses. Yes, what perspective? Groups, teams can be ineffective when they serve no real purpose, when they invite people to play roles that do not lead to task accomplishment. Dear friends, what is the process of group development? Forming. When everyone is at their best and optimistic, storming. Establish priorities, creating order and roles. Then norming, performing, and then adjourning. We did speak about these things before. People play different roles in teams. Innovator. Generate ideas and concepts, often impractical but stimulating. Worker. Practical. Buckles down to get the job done but may lack vision. Monitor and evaluator. Analyzes ideas and feasibilities. Can process complex data but may dominate too much with the practitioners. Teamwork skills. Take along and leave behind. Take along personal responsibility, ability to motivate the team, constructive competitive spirit, ability to look like your team, ability to laugh at yourself, ability to please your new boss and leave behind what? Personal glory, star mentality, destructive competitive spirit, old school uniform, like old things all, locker room jokes, no jokes in the team, it is a work team, your old coach ways of doing things, the old things need to be taken out. You also have the other roles like resource investigator, explorer. Resources and ideas outside the group may overextended and increase complexity but improves external contacts. Completer. Concerned about keeping on schedule and completing details. Often anxious but controlled and will work hard to meet goals. Free rider. See if others will pick up the slack. So there are cultural influences also in the group. You have to look into the cultural influences. So how do we make a team effective then? Recognition of the group process, planning, shared vision and common objectives, playing roles that help the group function, linking objectives to evaluate, and what gets rewarded is what gets done. So, see the picture which is given here, how the teamwork is helping people to cross the blocks. Business globalization project, pre-revolution. If we have to take up as a teamwork, attendance should be there, preparation should be there, quality of work should be there, team dynamics should be looked into. Symptoms of group dysfunction. One member dominates other. Disagreements do not lead to productivity. Members do not attend meetings or disrupt when they do attend. Silence is the norm. You wish you were in another team. No one acknowledges that the team has a problem. These are symptoms, dear friends. Consider your own experience. Yes, each one of you would have worked in teams, a lot of teams. Now you are working in a virtual team. What roles are most comfortable for you to play in a group or team? What are strengths and weaknesses of role playing in groups? How can your team enhance your strengths and minimize your weaknesses? Working in teams. Objectives. Be able to define team structure, develop a team process, learn about team culture. What type of team you should be taking? This is a team structure. What is the purpose of the team? Who is the leader of the team? Types of team, work team, task team, and management teams. Team size, team membership, team skills, and stability of the team. All these are needed. Purpose of the team. What is the purpose of the team? Each member must understand team members' interests. Goals. Once the team's purpose is clarified, team members must set the goal the team wishes to accomplish. Performance measures. In order to know how the team is performing, you have to have measures to gauge progress. How to choose measures, appropriateness of measures, progress towards content goals, progress towards process goals, and team member growth and development. Dear friends, leadership is very important to work in the team. If external, then only style command and control. Team needs to have ownership of their activities. Behaviors of the leader as a liaison member or resource provider or counselor. You can be a mentor, teacher and a challenger too. Team process. Renewal, formation first and the development and then the renewal. The formation. first meeting of the team, define what they need to accomplish and how the team will operate. Develop measures for short and long-term success. Establish ground rules of operation. Dear friends, ground rules are when and where the team meets, substitutes allowed at meetings, team records, what, who, when, how, work expectations of members, confidentiality and participation. Dear friends, when we talk about participation, conversation continuum should be there. It should be a closed one or open one. A closed one, open one, you have a debate, you have a dialogue, you have a discussion. So first you can go with the dialogue, then go with the discussion and debate over it. Verbal behaviors. What behaviors encourage effective participation? Set contest, ask questions of members, use supportive statements, seek out different perspectives and share feelings. Dear friends, contributor to the skills. Initiation. Draw out information, clarify ideas, energize, organize, build relationships, be flexible and learn. 5H program help aspect is working in these sessions, dear friends. Yes, business skills, we need to work on the help aspect very much. Adjustment, revisions of the initial rules of goals, a reality check of what can be accomplished. Breakpoint comes when the team gets mired in discussions. Development, you need to have reinforcement and cohesion. What is cohesion? Comes together as a team. High energy, high interest, progress is made, team is supportive, develop relationship. Dear friends, reinforcement is the other one of the where cohesion is built, homogeneity is built, team members are comfortable with each other, start to be interested in self-preservation and self-perpetuation. Goals should be on creativity and exploration. Renewal, learning and transformation. What is learning? Team learns new skills, build relationships to accomplish tasks, commitment and mutual accountability. Team may be confrontational over issues. Dear friends, talk about transformation. Excuse me. Results are produced from team activities. Innovative. To sustain energy, must press and press the team. Needs new challenges, new members, new tasks and new relationships. How do we go about the team culture? Team values, team rituals and team learning. How do we do team values? What are these team values? Commitment to tasks and team members. Accountability. Lead to trust between team members. What are team rituals? Rituals, yes, rituals. How to add new members is a ritual. How to provide information to new members. How a member exists. Work rituals, how to the team celebrates. Yes, we should celebrate. Team learning, continuous improvement process, how team resolves conflict, how the team handles diversity, harness team creativity. Essential skills for teamwork. Listening. There's a most important aspect, dear friend, listening. You should, instead of focusing on what they are trying to convey, we are thinking about what we are going to say next, in which time we have missed their entire point. So, what we should do is, the time to talk and time to listen. The time to listen comes twice as often as time to talk. Sacrifice. Each team member has to evaluate what they are truly willing to sacrifice and then continue to be willing when the time comes that they are asked to sacrifice. It could be everything from time to resources to positions of power. Sharing. The most important aspect of teamwork. What one person knows may be the key to another person's position's problem. We have to be willing to share those key even when it will make someone else look better. Yes, we have to share even the keys. Communication. When there are problems or successes, a team has to be willing to communicate effectively what went right and wrong. It is important to analyze issues that you have in project or as a team, but it is also important to analyze your success. Language. It is so important that you have an established habit of speaking in an uplifting way. If you are at all demeaning or domineering or insulting, it will grind the team to a halt. People will still be willing to sacrifice, share and discuss, just not with every member of the team. Meaning that the team just became rivals. So, please be careful of the language which you use. Hard work. Team members have to be willing to work hard on an individual basis and then turn that hard work over to the team so that as a whole, you can make your work meaningful and achieve a greater goal. Persuade. Everyone should be encouraged to exchange, defend, and then eventually rethink their ideas. You have to love your idea. But the team work takes individual work for a collective good that ultimately increases the good everyone is receiving. These skills are a basic list but will help you in the long way. You want to master them all in one day, but take every opportunity you can to practice them and they will help you. What are the other aspects? Conflict resolution in work teams. The process of building a team is no easy task. It requires a lot of commitment, cooperation and communication from all those involved. Dear friends, there are three secrets to motivate your team. On a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being highly motivated, how motivated is the team you manage? Keeping a good team together. The cornerstone of any successful company is the team that makes it up. There is no other more important contributing factor to building a truly great organization. Teamwork in the workplace. A definition is more important. A tight-knit team is a group of competent individuals who care deeply about each other. They are fiercely committed to their mission and are highly motivated to combining their energy and expertise to achieve a common objective. Dear friends, let's try building some teams. How can we build a team? I would like to tell a small story here. Good old lessons in teamwork from an age-old fable. Yes, the tortoise and the hare. You all know the story that the tortoise and hare had a race, and you know who won it? Tortoise. Why? The hare was in a hurry. So the moral of the story is to slow and steady wins the race. But this is the version of the story that we all are going grown up along with. Why can't we just sing the story continues? They all overconfident and careless and lax. So they all, what they have done, they have come near the spoon, let us understand how the story has been. There is a water, a small pond. How to cross? Now, hare can, tortoise can cross, but hare cannot cross. So, what to do? Here, again the story still is not ended. If there is a teamwork, what will they do? The tortoise will put the hare. First, the hare will take the tortoise up to the water, and the tortoise will take the hare on him, cross the water. Then again, the tortoise will be on the hare after reaching the goal. So both of them will reach the goal. What is the moral of the story? It's good to be individually brilliant and to have strong core competencies. But unless you are able to work in a team and harness each other's core competencies, you will always perform below par, because there will always be situation at which you will do poorly and someone else does well. So teamwork is mainly about situational leadership, letting the person with the relevant core competency for a situation to take leadership. Yes, friends. Now, this small story makes us understand in life, when we face with the failure, we should pick up and we should take the help. To sum up, the story of the hare and tortoise, which teaches us many things: never give up when faced with failure. Fast and consistent will always beat slow and steady. Work to your competencies. Compete against the situation, not against the rival. And pooling resources and working as a team will always beat individual performers. Yes, friends, let's go and build stronger teams. Now, here, if working together gives you a better understanding. So, what is a teamwork? Tools, experience. T stands for tools. E stands for experience. A stands for authorization. M for manpower. W for what else? O for orders and instructions. R for requirement. K for knock it off. Yes, with teamwork you can do this. So, dear friends, we should now understand the teamwork and go about it. Let us do a tutorial. Let's answer these questions. Essentials of great teamwork, individualism and teamwork, advantages and teamwork at the office, why teamwork needs a vision, why do teams fail, team building, why bother, top skills for corporate team building, how can improved teamwork help, work out a teamwork conference, ensure optimal performance of your team. Dear friends, take the tutorial of using Story Map Organizer. Build a story where your team has achieved with specific teamwork skills. That will help you to come out with it. With the story, you can build up the teamwork. Thank you.